Hello everyone, welcome back to some more Python programming, looking at the SymPy module. I'm Root of the Null, and we're going to be looking at equality. Now, I'm not talking about race or gender and equal rights and stuff. I'm talking about mathematical equality in symbolic computation, and in Python, and in SymPy. So, let's go ahead and import everything from SymPy, import all that jazz, and we're good to go. Let's actually create x, a little variable that we can work with. We know we do that with the symbols function, pass in a string for x. Oh, thanks for that autocomplete thing. Oh, that's really funny. All right, x equals symbols x. There we go. Okay, so the point of this tutorial is to talk about equal signs and equality. This is going through a little bit more of the online tutorial and the online documentation. So this whole series is for people that just don't like to read stuff. I just would much rather have it be presented to them. But here we go. Here we freaking go. What I want to talk about is this blessed equal sign. Typically, we've got an expression, right? We can say this expression, this is going to be our variable. It can equal the symbol x plus, let's say, 2. I don't care. Plus 2. And now we've got our expression working just fine with our x symbol, and that works fine for us. If I were to try and set this expression equal to 4, make it an equation, right? Ooh, now we're working, of course, with the variable. But this steps away from symbolic and symbolism stuff. Okay, symbolism is not the word that I want to go for, but it doesn't represent things symbolically. This expression variable is kind of a wrapper around the actual x plus 2 expression that we see in mathematics. It's the Python variable's representation of these symbols. So rather than working with the expression variable, we're going to work with the core x plus 2. Now, if we tried to set this x plus 2 equal to 4, we're going to get something weird. We get a syntax error, can't assign to operator. Python doesn't know WTF we're doing. So keep in mind here, this is a consequence of SymPy, that it doesn't extend Python syntax. The equals sign in Python is an assignment operator. This is hard-coded into the Python language, and SymPy isn't going to change that, you know? So how can we assign equality to this expression, like x plus 2? How can we make that equal 4? Well, that's not going to work for us. Maybe we can use two equal signs, right? This is a kind of a common notion or a common idea, but this is used for equality testing in Python, right? We typically like test if A is equal to B. This is what these two equal signs in conjunction are used for. That's used for equality testing. In SymPy, it's used for equality. That's not really correct either. If I said x plus 1 or our x plus 2, that if that's equal to 4, we get false. That's weird. Instead of treating x plus 2 equal to 4 symbolically, instead of having this returned to us, we just get this Boolean value false. Why is that? Now, in SymPy, these two equal signs represent exact structural equality testing. That means that like we saw earlier, A is equal to B, and it's going to return its if A is equal to B, just like we see in Python. And this is asking if A is equal to B. We're always going to get a Boolean variable. There is a separate object in SymPy that you're probably going to see a lot of. This is what is actually used to create symbolic equalities. It's EQ, capital EQ, for equality. X plus 2, our expression like we've seen, and it takes another argument to say what it's actually equal to. Let's set it equal to 4. Now what's going to be returned to us is x plus 2 equals 4. Because that's just what we've set as this equation now. You can think of EQ as equality, you can think of EQ as equation. Think of it however you'd really like, but know that, okay, now at this point in this equation, we can set this to a variable or something so we can keep working with it. But in this microcosm of the world, x plus 2 is equal to 4. This is going to be returned true. Now when we use this again, it's not going to return true for us because it's only in this function. It's in that microcosm of the world. So We'll see more of this later on, but that's how we actually use and create symbolic equalities. And there's another kind of caveat about our double equal sign. This is an interesting topic here. What if we wanted to tell the difference between an expanded form in mathematics and a factored form in mathematics? Obviously, these things are equal. Let's check it out. We still got our variable x, right? So, if I use parentheses x plus 1, and I bring this to the power of 2, let's say this is equals to x to the power of 2 plus 2 times x plus 1. So, a few mathematicians out there, you can easily see that this is the factored form, x plus 1 squared, and this is the expanded form, x squared plus 2x plus 1. Now, if I hit enter, we get false. Why is that? We know that these two things are equal, right? At least according to mathematics, right? Did we, like, find a bug in SymPy? Did we break the world of math? What's going on? X plus 1 squared does equal x squared plus 2x plus x, but keep in mind that our equals represents exact structural equality testing. Exact. This means that the two expressions that are compared, if A is equal to B, have to be literally the exact thing. They're not the same symbolically. X plus 1 squared does not equal x squared plus 2x plus 1 symbolically. And I don't know, that's a weird kind of word to throw around now, symbolically. You can just hey man, take over the world, symbolically. Now, one is the power of an addition of two items, and the other is an addition of three items. X plus 1 squared, x plus 2x plus 1, x plus 2, blah, blah, blah. So, using SymPy as a library, using this equals test, is fine for exact symbolic equality, but it's more useful than representing symbolic equality, or even test for mathematic equality. You probably care about mathematic equality. So, we've seen the alternative to this. We can use and set things equal with our EQ function, but it doesn't really determine whether or not things truly are equal, like this thing. X plus 1 squared equals x squared plus 2x plus 1. What if we really want to know that, okay, yeah, these things are equal? The way that we do this, pretty much, is by testing if this minus this is equal to 0. And, I mean, I guess this could work for us, right? No. The way that we do this is we actually pass in a function that's part of SymPy and that we'll learn more and more about later, but it's simplify. Do my braces match up? I don't think they do. My parentheses match up? No. Simplify minus this. Now we get 0. Okay, so now this is telling us that, yeah, these things are equal. But it's interesting, and I'll actually show this off in a coming video. This method is not infallible. That's at least what the documentation tutorial online says. In fact, it can be theoretically proven. It is impossible to determine if two symbolic expressions are identically equal in general. But for most common expressions, this works for us. So hey, that's a really cool thing. And I'll show that off in a later tutorial. At least, not a later tutorial, but an interesting video that it's theoretically proven. You can't prove two equal things truly are equal to each other. So I guess I'll kind of leave off on that. Before I go, actually, there is another method, another function, equals. And what this one does is it tests if two expressions are equal to each other by evaluating them at random points. So if I had my thing here inside my simplify function, took all this jazz, and I just threw it in here. It takes it as a dot operator. Let's say A, our new symbol. What that's going to do is we'll equal our x plus 1 squared, and B can equal the other end of that, our x squared plus 2 times x plus 1. We could use now simplify A minus B, and we get 0, because we're looking at the exact same thing again. And we can also use A dot A being obviously this expression, and dot using a function of that, A dot equals, and I will pass in other. It returns true if self is equal to other, false if doesn't or not. And A dot equals B, and this is going to equal true for us. This is going to return a Boolean value. And the way that does that is by evaluating these expressions at a random point, or a random value. So that's the way that it works. Okay, that's enough talking. That's kind of a bunch of the equality stuff that I wanted to kind of just spew out to you guys. Hope you can retain all that. EQ is the way we can look at equality or set things equal to each other. The double-double equal sign is testing for exact equality. And you've got other functions like simplify and equals that you can play with if you need to. But, I mean, there they are, guys. Here, I'm just handing them to you. Take them out. I'm take 12, take 9. I mean, I got to get rid of them at all. All right. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you're enjoying the series. Hope you're enjoying the videos. If you do like it, please like the video. Please comment. Tell me what you're thinking. Maybe subscribe. All up to you. I'll see you in the next tutorial.